First, it warned of delays in the postal service because of unofficial industrial action by members of the Communication Workers Union at the Dublin Mail Centre. 300,000 letter deliveries weren't processed last night and won't be delivered today. It's because members of the Amalgamated Postal Branch of the Union have introduced their own shift and duty arrangements. 250,000 of the letters are destined for the provinces. The Taoiseach is meeting the Taoiseach ahead of this morning's cabinet meeting to discuss the row that's developed over the granting of Irish citizenship to a couple from the Middle East. They were granted Irish passports after they invested in the Reynolds family's pet food business. Last night, Dick Springs said the circumstances seemed at one with the categories in the citizenship scheme accepted by all parties in government since 1986. Gardaí have named the 30-year-old woman who died after being hit by a car that failed to stop in Dublin last night. Clodagh Lee from Corrine in County Waterford was cycling on Whitehall Road East in Terenure when the accident happened. Gardaí say Miss Lee was studying on a course in the capital. They're investigating reports of a stolen car. The RUC say three youths are in hospital after they collided in a stolen car with a British Army Land Rover on the Falls Road in West Belfast this morning. Firemen had to use cutting gear to free the youths from the car. After the crash, two of them are said to be seriously ill. And the weather forecast, continuing dry in most places with good brighter sunny spells, especially over Munster and South Leinster. Rather cloudy in the extreme north and northwest with some patchy drizzle or light rain for a time. And the highest afternoon temperature 16 to 20 Celsius, but cooler on exposed coasts. I'll be back with more news at midday.
A very good morning to you, Ryan, on the radio. It's a very special day, not quite. Are we through Oaken Midday? Yes, we are actually through the whole way through Oaken Midday. The studio is in complete chaos, as is my life. But of course, it's in the midst of a 15th anniversary, and these things do happen. So once again, we offer you the opportunity, as we've been doing for the last couple of years, to dial us on the Ryan line. The number has changed on occasion. And if the news would like to just slip out, because I can see a gentleman who's looking for... Do you want to escape? Stay! There's extra money, don't worry. 1850, 85, 22, 22. Now, I was watching young Dempsey from the comfort of my own bed this morning, and I could see that there was a certain degree of chaos beginning to reign in here. My old friend Brian O'Brien from television's over attempting to give some sort of, some level of sanity across down as we've calmed things down just a little bit. I'll just explain what we've got to do. We've got two cameras, we've got a whole lot of people I've never seen before, and we've got a bunch of my colleagues and friends. Object of the exercise is to let you at home in on what's been happening over the last 2 years behind the scenes. But of course, it's a bit of a lie, because we've only had this studio for about a year or so. This is the state of the art. This is the ultimate. This is about as good as it gets in radio terms. And we had promised ourselves we'd never let you in backstage until such time as we've got lots of your hard-earned cash and showed you what it could really be spent on. So you're welcome. Join us today on 1850, 85, 22, 22. What I'd particularly like to do, maybe, if any of you could possibly, with whatever grey matter is left, cast your minds back over the last 15 years and try and remember exactly what you were doing around that time, any particular memories that you may have of the very early days. And yesterday I spoke to Barry Lang about what exactly he was putting this tape together for. There was myself, there was Simon Young, and there was Ian Dempsey, and he was attempting to try and remind us of what we did on the first day. And I, for the love of me, cannot. I have a vague recollection presiding over a press release which insinuated that the most interesting thing that I did at that time was eat ratatouille sandwiches. I do remember being introduced to the then Director General and, of course, the higher echelon of RTE Radio at the time, and they basically looked at most of us, especially me, and just went, it's a sad day for RTE, really, isn't it? It was, I suppose, the best way of putting it. And that's my only memory. I can't remember what the first show was like. Does anybody out there who can help us, please give us a buzz. I can't remember what it was even called. Give us a chance for me, John. Aidan, good morning to you.
Hey, good morning, Gerry. Yeah.
How are you?
Yeah, fine, Paul, yeah.
Now, Aidan, what's the business?
Well, just walked into the shop yesterday and found a football in the fridge.
Ah.
Full of ice cream.
Let me remind people what this gentleman has just stumbled upon. Yesterday, Brenda Donoghue announced the fact that 15 footballs, very special World Cup footballs, would be deposited in various selections around the country over the next few days. She herself was in proud possession of three of them. Now, the object of the exercise is for you to scour the length and breadth of the nation. with a few hints, and very few, and some of them not all that interesting either for that matter. But when you found that football, and it's a white and blue yolk, right, not particularly difficult to find. This is not a serious search. When you see it, you'll know exactly what you've been looking for. It's white and blue with the odd bit of a Mars and indeed Snickers logoing on it. It's covered in a kind of a blue net. I think it's a blue net around the gem, and it's got a little tag on it. The tag says, congratulations from Mars at 2FM. And there's a security code at the end of it, and it tells you then the moment you find this football, you've got to ring the Gerry Ryan Show, sometime between 9 and 12. Quote your security code, though not live on air, because that will lead to a load of charlatans trying to take away your glory. And if you're lucky, well, you will be included on the June the 8th draw of myself and Des Cal. But more to the point, you could find yourself in LA for the World Cup final in the United States of America on July the 17th. That's just what's happening to you, Creedon. Where did you find it?
I'm the bus stop news agent on Eden Key.
And were you looking for it?
Not at all, no. I was looking for some ice cream or some milk and stuff.
And did you know what it was about?
I had no clue, no. I was just like, I started asking some people, but I just started, I read the card instead and...
That's rather extraordinary accent, Aiden, by the way. Where do you come from?
Zimbabwe, originally.
Ah, thought so. Yeah. How long have you been over here?
About 4 or 5 years now.
Why did you leave Zimbabwe?
It was just too hot and too peace, you know, too nice.
Too hot and too nice?
No.
Sounds like a good enough reason to stay.
Yeah.
All right, well, good luck. You know what this means now? June the 8th, you're entitled to be included in the draw. Myself and Mr. Fair and Mr. Honest and Mr. Highly Informed Des Cal will preside over the initiation. And who knows? You might be the name that goes forward for July the 17th.
Brilliant. Great.
Good luck to you.
Thanks,
Jerry. Take care. Now, let me continue to observe the possibilities on my computer screen. Muriel on line 2. Hello, how are you?
Good morning, Jerry.
How are you?
Not too bad.
Now, this woman is kind of intent on putting a dampener on the whole thing. Yeah?
Well, it's been a kind of public attention in our house for a few years now, as to the actual date, starting date of 2FM.
As to the actual... Well, my recollection is that it was the 31st of May, 1979.
Okay.
And I was there.
You were there.
Proving that I am one of the oldest inhabitants of the building.
Well, I'll tell you what my memory of it is.
What's your...
Well, my memory of it is my son was born on Sunday the 27th of May 1979, and my recollection is that 2FM came on air on the Monday morning. That would be the 28th. And the other reason I remember it so well is that there was a petrol strike on at the time, a very severe petrol strike. And I was living in Kilkenny and I had my son in hospital in Waterford.
Yeah.
And nobody was listening. Because they had no petrol.
Now, these are all very interesting facts, and I do not dispute that indeed it was a petrol strike on, and that indeed your son might have been in hospital, and that nobody would visit you, etc., etc. But I am absolutely sure that it was the 31st of May.
Well, I'm here
to prove you wrong. Maybe. It's quite possible we could have had test transmissions on.
Well, maybe, but I remember the big flash, and as far as I remember, it was the old singer, Terence, Gogan opened.
No, I think it was Brenda Donoghue, wasn't it? It was a Brenda, it was Gary, yeah.
Well, you're set on confusing me then, but I'm sorry to remember that, but it started on the Monday morning. But tell me otherwise, Gary,
To prove it to you one as well, I'm not in a position to do, I don't have the archives here, so I can't. By the way, if you're interested, folks, there's the football, okay?
Sure.
That's what it looks like.
On television, we'll show the footage of it going on air.
Half 12 on television,
Network 2. Show the footage.
But does that show the date, dear? Well, there you have
it. And it was definitely the 31st.
It was definitely the 31st.
That was Thursday. Did you come on air on a Thursday?
Now, hold on a second. This was 16 years ago. Do you think I can remember whether it was a Thursday?
Well, I can remember it distinctly. I remember it really well.
It's a miracle that I can remember how to get to
the studio. I have a 15-year-old at home to film it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yeah. And were your dates that accurate, were they?
My dates are very accurate.
Come on, take the ball. Get the tail. That's the ball, by the way, because you're really interested. All right, 12:30 today on Network 2. You keep an eye right to your television.
Hang on,
Dave.
Just put that 15-year-old
back to start with Junior. Yeah, hold on a second. I've got somebody else who might be able to participate here. Good morning.
Hello, Gerry.
Right, say hello to Muriel.
Hi, Muriel.
Hi, how are you?
I'm having a lot of trouble with this woman, to put it mildly. She's not making my day.
Yeah. Well, I was just listening there, Gerry. She mentioned about the petrol strike. I don't know what it was, but it's the petrol tankers or the Gold War or something.
The petrol strike, Muriel, I think, wasn't it?
The petrol strike, yeah. I think it was around the high price of the oil.
I remember it was around, I think we had to queue for petrol from about 8:30 in the morning, six or more. And I was on my 51st car, and we started on the car, and that was a great radio station to listen to. But 2FM came on, and Declan Meehan.
Ah, Declan.
He was on. Declan Meehan.
Declan was still pinch it'd be a bar or a block.
Yeah, but I remember the way this is like you have down here now, I'm stuck in a van here now in the shade. It's beautiful.
Is that a description of weather? Stuck in a van in the shade?
In the shade, yeah, from the heat. Down to 20 degrees. It's beautiful here today.
It's good, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. But just cold morning, getting out of bed at around 6 o'clock, the queue for petrol, and the queues are maybe half, three quarters of the way long.
Yeah.
And you're on your little guest to go to for petrol.
That's right, they were hard days, weren't they?
They were wicked.
There before the arc.
In fact, there was a garage in Kilkenny that used to supply me with petrol to go down to my hospital visits, and in case of emergency, he would always have a tank on hand for me.
Ah, come on, that's no business. Like, this is like going back to the days when we used to all make our own brown bread. And the entire family would go to mass in the broken cathedral on one bill, boys. Barry, good morning to you.
Good morning, Gerry.
Say hello to Muriel and Pat.
Good morning, Muriel and Pat.
Hello.
Muriel and Pat are back 89 years of age, right?
Thank you, Gerry.
How are you, Murray?
I'm fine, Gerry.
Now, is Murray joining the debate on whether it was actually the very
first? It was on Thursday, because I was on my way home from Hollis Street Hospital to Blessington in County Wicklow when I delivered my son.
And you delivered your son to Blessington in County Wicklow?
No, in Hollis Street. I was on my way home to Blessington.
Right, with it.
Yeah. From Hollis Street on the Thursday when it came on 2FM. And it was absolutely brilliant. And I always said I would remember 2FM from there on, because I was at a height of excitement. I had just delivered.
You were in the height of excitement?
Yes, I was. I was on my way home with my £10 1 ounce son.
God, that was a cracker, wasn't it?
Yes.
£10 1 ounce.
And I'm only 5 foot high.
Yes, good woman. In Russia, then, you're giving me a medal for that.
I deserve one.
So it was definitely
on purpose. Yes.
Now, sorry, can I just return now to Muriel?
Yeah.
Are we satisfied?
Well, I suppose so. I have to do
that. Hold on, when we
think it's not approved. My son was born on the 25th of May, which was a Friday. He was born at 9:05 on the Friday, the 25th of May.
Well, that's very nice, Murray, but that's nothing really to do with the conversation. Hold on for a second. Marge, come in.
Good morning, Murray.
Say hello to Muriel, Murray and Pat.
Hello, Muriel, Murray and Pat.
Hello, Murray. She's great memory, guys, isn't she?
I unfortunately couldn't enjoy the beginning of 2FM.
Ah.
Yes, because I was bringing my 5-year-old daughter to London for open heart surgery. But on the day he opened, I was bringing my year-old to my sister out in the country and my 2-year-old to my mother. And I unfortunately couldn't enjoy it. My daughter had to go to London for a second time for open heart surgery, and we came strong after.
But just to go back for a moment, hold on a second. You remember the day that you were bringing your daughter categorically for her open heart surgery as the 31st? Yeah.
So on the Thursday, I'm flying out on Saturday. On the Thursday, the 31st, I was bringing my year-old to Kilmarnock to my sister's house. And she was the year-old on the 29th, and I was going out on the Thursday. And I flew off on the Saturday.
And what happened?
My daughter had open heart surgery for the second time.
How old was she?
She was 5 the day we came home at the end of June.
Yeah.
And she had a stroke after a second operation, which left her paralysed down one side and gave her tunnel vision.
Oh dear God, 5 years of age.
Yes, it was her second time. The first time she was in a year and 10 months. She's fine now. She's going on 20 now.
Did she recover from the stroke?
A lot of hard work and a lot of physiotherapy.
Yeah. Yeah, huge amount of physiotherapy, yes. Okay, yeah.
She was, I think, about 10 before she learned to pedal her bike, because she couldn't get the coordination together.
Yeah.
She's grand now though. I mean, she's big and bow like all the young ones of that age. But it was a lot of hard work and it was a lot of pressure, and it was hard for us because we had no family especially in London.
Yeah.
And there was both a strike as well at the time.
So I'd say the opening of 2FM or Radio 2 as it was known then was not of particular interest to you.
No, it wasn't. I had too much more on my mind.
Yeah. And understandably so. But all's well that ends well.
Oh, it is. Good. I mean, there are some of them that are happy for us, but some of them are very, very sad.
Well, I mean, I'd say it's a long and hard fight. Anyway, you've just put the whole conversation into context.
Okay,
our argument and shouting and screaming about the day pales into insignificance after that. Doesn't it, folks? Do you agree?
I agree. Yeah, that's proof positive, Gerry. Yeah, I stand corrected.
You stand corrected. Okay.
And also, Gerry,
one more thing.
Yes, I'm married here. No. When I arrived home in Blessington that day, Saturday.
With your £10 2F run.
With my £10 one out. Graham, my husband had a bottle of champagne for me when we arrived home. He was on delivery, and I'm just wishing now that I had a bottle of champagne, just like you, to be sipping on now.
Oh God, he saw me sipping the champagne.
Yes, I did.
That doesn't normally
happen. I'm here watching down the telly.
There you go, that's a semi-state bottle of champagne.
I'm in the heart of Westford now, and it's absolutely beautiful.
Oh, I did tell you what, a bottle of champagne for you, it's on the house.
Oh, yes?
Yeah.
Well, yeah. I leave my bed when I go off the
bed. I'm sure you will.
Yeah.
I'm sure you will.
Gerry, this is Marge here in Limerick. My daughters are wrong here. What about the champagne for us?
Yes.
If the fellas who sponsored us during the Eurovision are willing to send out the bottles of champagne, they're yours.
Bye. Thank you,
Gerry.
Bye, Gerry.
Thank you very much. Right, it's only when you hear a story like the open heart surgery story that you realise that all the screaming and roaring that we go on with sometimes is a wee bit on the exaggerated side, and we do get carried away, and we need something like that to put it all into context. Right, time for some music. I got there. Right, roll it. Mighty McDonald's, Sweet Freedom. Thousands of pounds developing and putting together, and do you think that he would go, Oh yes, Terence, a pimple. What a good idea. Let's get rid of the other logo that we spent years working up and put a nice big pimple on all our merchandising from now on.
No, we won't.
No.
But what happens to him anyway, Terence? Same mistake.
What?
I mean, you know, can't find to read.
I'll listen to all the time. Would you like a little drop of champagne?
I would if I mind if I do.
Okay, look.
But you don't know that.
Very expensive glasses that I brought in. Now, what do you notice around the studio that's a bit different from usual?
You swear we're at the venue, the camera, didn't you?
Yes, well, why would you think that is?
What?
Why would you think that is, dear?
If you talk around the telly?
That's absolutely correct. We're on the telly.
Oh, come here, can I say hello to all the people watching on the telly?
Yes, of course you can.
Especially the greeting to everyone who's watching on the telly, especially people in the hospital, who are probably watching, especially the children's ward. Gerry, preventing me growing toenails back in April. In the children's ward, it would make.
You must have been the biggest child of the cop.
I've got that,
have you a message?
I have, and hello to all the bus drivers that are driving around Dublin and Cork today watching us on the telly. Do you know they watch on the telly now on the buses?
Do they?
The bus drivers have a television and
television. I didn't know they television.
They do. But then the bandits get out of the they put on their watch, keeping quiet up there.
Do you like that? Do you like champagne, do you?
No.
I find it gives me indigestion.
Not really. When you know me, no, Blake.
If I don't drink enough, but... Mom, mind you, if there's anybody out there who wants to actually take this call seriously, 1850 85 22 22, we'll take your calls.
Could I have put him down?
Now,
oh,
course,
God, Terry, don't say that.
Yes, you could have him put down, that's true.
No, I mean put him down, mate. Bring him out to the hall and they are a silly moss. And when he's still being put down, it's a euro winner and a loser.
You mean like humiliate him?
Put him down then.
You never know, there any moment we might actually get somebody ringing up who might actually have some suggestion by way of advice for you, but it's highly unlikely.
Well, when he was a young pup, he was very nervous for the people he's taken walking, so maybe that has something to do with it.
Yeah.
And
was he kicked or beaten savagely as a young pup?
Well, we got him when he was 9 weeks, and I doubt it.
No, I'm only joking.
Did you not hear what Terence said? You have to keep him a bit too savagely.
I'm only joking about that. I might have it, though.
Yeah, I think he's Scottish.
And often as a dog, they're inclined to imitate their owners. You don't bark, do you? No?
Dave, that sounded like a bark. Do that again.
Well, you see, are you shouting, lad? Are you shouting the road around the house?
No.
No, that could be it, though.
Wait, go back, put the camera back.
Where's your garden, Gerry?
What garden? Shut up! Donoghue. We do have a garden. We have a garden. We'll be seeing it. Yeah. We'll show it in the garden now in just a minute. We'll be showing you the garden. Bernie, good morning.
Hi, Gerry. How's it going?
Say hello to Jackie.
Hello, Jackie. Hi, Bernie. Bernie. How are you? Do you remember the lunch you got cake for us?
Are you talking to me or Jackie, though?
Bernie, can I just come across this for a moment? Have you a solution to Jackie's problem regarding the psychopathic and pathologically dangerous dog? No.
Oh, temper, temper. hung up.
That's lovely. Do you know what?
You won't be getting the £58,000 giveaway, the 18 tickets to LA for the World Cup final.
You haven't hit the 7 collar. Yeah, yeah,
okay, we've got to have some music.
Yeah,
was I wearing my good tempo?
You were, but I know what happened. Like, you might know the ring might get. I mean, he snuck in here during the night, past the queue, and wrote his name on your headphones just off stage,
Yeah, well, it's possible. Let's have some music. I gather it's from what?
Wham.
And it's called Wake Me Up Before You Go Wrong.
And it's from Wham.
Thank you.